joy no matter what.
Philippians 1:12-14 says, "Now I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that what has happened to me has actually served to advance the gospel. As a result, it has become clear throughout the whole palace guard and to everyone else that I am in chains for Christ. And because of my chains, most of the brothers and sisters have become confident in the Lord and dare all the more to proclaim the gospel without fear."
Here at the beginning of Philippians, we read that not only was Paul a prisoner, but he lived his life chained to a prison guard 24 hours a day. He never knew if he would be released from prison, soon face death, or live to see another day. His life was in limbo. It would be reasonable to think that this letter to the Philippians would be full of worry and anxiety, but that was not the case. You might also assume that somewhere in this letter, Paul would ask for help to get out of prison or that he would complain about his current situation, but he didn't. Paul's life inside a dirty, lonely jail was a testament of his faith in God. Because of the pandemic, your current situation might feel a little bit like an imprisonment. You can't go where you want to go, be with the people you want to spend time with, or do the things that you want to do. All of us are living in limbo. We don't know what will happen next. But our situation is temporary. It won't last forever. Paul knew this as well. Because he lived with such strong faith in God, other believers gained confidence and were bold in sharing the gospel.
What about your life right now makes you feel like a prisoner? What do you not like about your situation? How can you find joy in your current situation? What opportunities might be present? Who in your life encourages you when you're going through a tough time? What do they do to encourage you?
Thank you. Dear God, I just come to you today and I just pray that we would approach you with confidence and that we would not be afraid to talk to you because we know that you were always there for us and that we can come to you with anything. And God, just give us faith and just help us to believe that you were there and that you listen to us and care for us. And I thank you for all that you've done for us and the many blessings that you've given us. In Jesus' name, amen.